Okay, now that we've gone through our design and development process, we're going to move into connecting a custom domain. This lesson will be pretty quick. Now, we can always export content and upload it externally using something like FTP, but what we're going to focus on in this lesson is single button publishing, so we can get our live site up instantly to our main.com. And we'll do this in 5 parts. We'll add our domain, we'll update our DNS settings, we'll verify that those DNS settings have been properly connected, we'll set the default version of our site to www.carbeek.com, and of course, we'll publish our project. So let's start with adding. And of course, by default, what we did before, if we go to publish, we can see that we have our staging domain. This is our .webflow.io domain. So we can use this to stage, or if we just want to use the .webflow.io domain, we can do that there. In this case, of course, we want to add our custom domain. So we'll click to add. So this is where you can add a site plan if you haven't already. If you've already added a site plan, you'll see exactly what we see on the screen, which is where we can add our custom domain. So let's press add a custom domain, and we're going to type it in right here. Now, if you haven't already purchased a custom domain, you can do so right here, buy a new domain. Or for us, we already have an existing one, and we'll walk through that now. So we'll go carbeek.com. And of course, we'll go over to add domain. Now, we've chosen GoDaddy as the example here because we can see we actually have 2 options here in Webflow. When we add that domain, because we've registered it at GoDaddy, we have 2 options. We can connect automatically, which is always very convenient, and that could work fine. Or in this case, let's demonstrate what happens when we connect manually. DNS configuration can sometimes be a bit complex, especially if you already have existing A records, existing records that you're modifying in your DNS. Fortunately, we have all of that on Webflow University. So check that out if you haven't already. For us, we're going to demonstrate what that looks like with GoDaddy manually. But that's adding the domain. So let's move on and update the DNS. Now, when we do this, we're going to see 2 things added to our screen, 2 sections. We'll see the section for carbeek.com. We'll also see the section for www.carbeek.com. So we'll make the www version in the next step. We'll make it our default. But for right now, let's start by adding the records, adding these values to carbeek.com. And we can do that in GoDaddy. So let's go over to GoDaddy. We've censored out some of these domain names because they contain top secret, privileged, confidential information, future products, trade secrets, things of that sort. And what we'll do here is go to carbeek.com. We'll go to the 3 dots. Of course, we can go to manage DNS. Of course, when we're there, let's take a look. So by default, we have a couple things, like for instance, this A record is parked by default by GoDaddy. This is a new domain for us. You could see different values depending on if this is an existing site that's routing somewhere else. That's fine. So a couple things to note in this example. Let's make sure to delete any existing A records that have a host name, a name of @. So let's remove this, just delete that parked record to make it a little bit cleaner for us. And then of course, anything that's a CNAME for www, let's remove that so we can create a new record in just a moment. Of course, it always makes sense to take a screenshot before you do something like this, to take a screenshot or to otherwise backup, write down your DNS settings. And if there's ever confusion about how to set this up or confusion about how the console or the settings area, DNS management area looks or feels or how it's operating, you can always reach out to your domain registrar directly and they can help you get this configured. But for us, we're going to go back to Webflow. And in Webflow, we have 2 A records we want to add, and we have 2 different values. Now, we can remember the A and the @. Let's click this value. That'll copy it to our clipboard, and we can add our first one. So again, we're going to go to add, and we'll choose a type. We know it's an A record, so let's choose A record, @. And of course, we'll paste that value, Command V, we'll paste that value from our clipboard. Let's leave time till live default, and hit add record. So, success, that's our first one. Let's go back and add the second one. So we'll copy this second value to our clipboard, back to GoDaddy. Let's go to add. We've been through this before, so type is A. We want @ for the name. And of course, let's paste this new value. That's 2/3 of the process. Let's add the third. So let's go back to Carbeek, and we can see that's really all we need in this version of it, in carbeek.com. The third is located under the www version. So that third type is CNAME with the name of www. So very similar process here. We see CNAME here, but this is their domain connect. That's okay, we can leave that. Let's go to add, and we'll add a CNAME record. For name, let's do www. And of course, for that value, let's make sure to grab that proxy SSL proxy-ssl.webflow.com in the value. Now, these numbers might look different. In your configuration, you might have something different in your dashboard. These numbers can change from time to time. So make sure to consult, make sure to reference, of course, these current values here. Don't just follow the ones in this video. If yours are different, make sure you check here or of course on Webflow University. So back over here in domain, we have that. Let's make sure to add that record. So now that that's been done, we can go ahead and check status. So we can check the status of our carbeak.com, our A record configuration here. Let's press check status. And of course it works, it's connected. Now keep in mind, it could take a few hours for domain changes to propagate, for these domain changes to take effect. So if it says not connected right away, and you go back and you check to make sure it's been added the right way, if it says issues detected on this top one, give it a few hours and check again to make sure it's updated. For us, it does say connected here, so we'll move on to the Carbeak version and let's press check status there. Both appear connected. Now, that is of course configuring our DNS. Again, your settings might be very different than this. That's okay. Check out Webflow University for the most up-to-date documentation on connecting a custom domain. For us, we're gonna move on to setting our default domain. And in this case, we're going to go and set the www.carbeak.com. We're gonna set that as the default. And when we do, of course, we now see that carbeak.com, www.carbeak.com is the default. What does that mean? It means if someone types www.carbeak.com, of course it'll take them to that site, but it also means if someone types just carbeak.com, carbeak.com will also route them to the proper, the default domain, www.carbeak.com. So now that that's done, we can move on to our last step. And of course that is publishing. You can publish from a number of different places in Webflow. You can publish from the page that we just added everything on the top right. We can publish from the editor, the Webflow editor. But in this case, we're in the Webflow designer. This is where we normally design our project. We just go up to publish up here, same place we published to our staging domain. And we can check carbeak.com, the www version has been added. And we can simply press publish to selected domains. And just like that, it's published successfully. Now, a couple things to note. Number one, you can see that, of course, we published to both of these. Do we need to keep that .webflow.io version? Well, sometimes it's helpful, especially if we're doing kind of rolling releases or we're testing some of our updates. We could actually uncheck carbeak.com. It's still published. Notice how we can unpublish it. And we can just publish an incremental version and test it out on our staging domain. So a lot of people like to leave the staging domain, the webflow.io version, for staging. So you could publish it to both. In fact, if we go to our site settings, our project settings, and go to the SEO tab, we can see under indexing that we have disable Webflow subdomain indexing checked to yes. Why so many syllables? What does this even mean? Well, what it's indicating here is if this is checked to yes, it's going to disable indexing for search engines on the staging domain. That means search engines won't see two entries, two identical sites in terms of our .webflow.io subdomain, and of course, in terms of our custom domain, our .com. So by turning this on, by having it disabled, that's usually the preferred way to do this, by having it disabled, that means when we publish, even if we're publishing to carbeakofficial.webflow.io and we're publishing to carbeak.com, it will only index, our search engines will only index the .com version. That of course signals to search engines not to index the .webflow.io version as well as the .com, but just index the .com. But that is it. We just connected our custom domain. We added the domain in our project settings. We updated DNS. We found out what DNS stands for.
No, we didn't.
We verified that DNS information. We set the default domain to www. We published, which for fun, we're going to do again right now. Except, yes, macOS is doing yet another update.
My staging domain is classified, but my public website is grimmergrimson.com. Lightning fast response times all over the world. Enterprise grade security, auto scales on demand as usual, goes through the roof. And global CDN, what is that? I don't know, but it's good. Wait, Grimmer, are you doing an ad? I'm not an ad man, that's not me. But if I was, I'd be great at it. It's not a plug for Webflow hosting, it is a plug for my personal website, grimmergrimson.com. And you know what? I want to shamelessly plug your website too. Business website? Good. Portfolio? Even better. Send it to me. Send it to me now. Send me your custom domain. Custom. 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 Custom.